Cultivation of mind should be the ultimate aim of human existence. Quote from Dr. B. R. Ambedkar, the father of the Constitution of India. Today is the day when we got our Constitution, 26 January, Indian Republic Day. Wake up and value the day. A very good morning to all the shining stars of Divine Providence School. This is Mrs. Deepa Pillai present among you all today to celebrate our 72nd Republic Day. This is the day when Constitution of India officially came into effect in 1950. A thoughtful mind, when it sees a nation's flag, sees not the flag, but the nation itself, that is equally a symbol of our duties. On this occasion of 72nd Republic Day of India, the national flag is hoisted by our respected Chairman, Reverend Father Manoj Augustine, accompanied by Reverend Father Sebastian Anthony. Memories in our souls. On this Republic Day, let's salute our nation with a patriotic song by our respected teachers.
Thank you.
our Honorable Principal, Reverend Father Sebastian Anthony, will address us and give his valuable inputs to our children on this special day.
Dear Reverend Father, Manoj, our Chairman, Reverend Father Tejish, dear Cha, Reverend Brother Levy, the Manager, dear Sister Sheba, the Coordinator, dear Savita Ma, our dearest Vice Principal, and you, dear students. It's a day of honor and pride for each one of us as we celebrate the 72nd Republic Day of our mother nation. On this day, I wish to give you no other beautiful and meaningful message than what our Constitution gives us in its preamble. It says, "We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic, and political liberty of thoughts, expression, belief, faith, and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and the integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact, and give ourselves this Constitution." Yes, dear students, the Constitution presents before us the soul of India. And this preamble speaks about the life of this soul, or the very core of what it is all about. And we are proud that we have a written constitution, unlike many other countries which do not have a written and constituted constitution. We have it, everything in clear cut. And we need to be proud again that this constitution gives each and every citizen of our country the opportunity and the equal status to get the rights as well as to fulfill their duties as citizens of India. When we speak about the so-called term republic, the Latin term means something of the public. And thus, it means our country is not the possession, or it is not under the possession of anyone, but it is a public affair. Every citizen of India has a right to be the makers of this India and to be the rulers of this India. Now, such a republic state is something in which the supreme power is held by the people and their elected representatives. And there is nobody who holds the power like in monarchy or somewhere in the time where there was a lot of so-called rigid rules governed only by the kings and the nobles or their family members. But in India, everyone, right from a daily laborer to the richest person, has the power and has the right to be elected as a supreme power, supreme ruler of this country. That's the beauty we are holding on to. And we have the examples of many of our presidents who come from the very low state or even from the high states. That is what we are professing every day. We are a republic, we are a secular, we are a democratic country. And today, on this day, I wish every one of you to reinstate in your minds this wonderful message that is given in the preamble itself in our constitution. We constitute India to be sovereign, reign by on its own without any external force. Socialist, giving everybody equal status. Secular, there is no force or any of your beliefs or anything. Democratic, ruled by the people itself. And republic, anybody and everybody in this India is equal and equal in holding the power. So I wish everyone to be members of this great nation, to be citizens of this nation, to be children of this mother India, that we grow together as responsible citizens, enacting our duties and living the rights for us and for each one around us. Jai Hind, be good citizens. Have a nice day.
Thank you, Father, for such an inspiring speech. Let us remember the golden heritage of our country and feel proud to be a part of India. Our talented students had done a beautiful performance. The performance is a tribute to our leaders.
Da 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 da. Ooh.
That was a good performance. Now, our respected Chitra ma'am will honor the sacrifices of heroes who made this day a special day for all Indians.
A very good morning to our respected chairman, Reverend Father Manoj Augustine, Principal, Reverend Father Sebastian Anthony, HR, Reverend Father Chidish, Manager, Brother Ravi, Sister Sheba, the Primary Level Coordinator, Vice Principal Sabida Ma'am, dear teachers and my new students. Today we are here to celebrate the 72nd Republic Day of our nation. Every year we celebrate the Republic Day on 26th January because the Constitution of India came to force on this day in 1950. The Indian Constitution came into existence after many debates and amendments. On 26 November 1949, the drafting committee of the Constitution was formed. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was the chairperson of the committee. On 26 January 1950, the Constitution came into existence and India became a republic country. What is a republic country? In a republic country, the citizens hold the supreme power to elect the representatives of the country. Indian Constitution gives us same rights despite any difference of caste, religion, language, color, etc. We celebrate the Republic Day with a lot of joy and patriotism. A grand celebration of the Republic Day is held in Delhi. On this day, ceremonial parades take place at the Rajpath. The President of India hoists the national flag and addresses the nation with his Republic Day speech. The prestigious awards of the country are distributed to the martyrs and civilians on this day. The Republic Day is the day to remember the sacrifice of thousands of the great leaders and freedom fighters who had lost their lives, who had struggled and suffered their entire life for the independence of the nation. Yes, we must remember the contribution of the social reformers who had uplifted the life of Indian women, who had propagated the value of education, and who had raised their voice against the superstitious beliefs existed in India. It's a day that makes us think beyond caste, creed, language or state, and we all feel the same emotion of love for our mother India. Dr. Kalam said, if a country is to be corruption free and become a nation of beautiful minds, I strongly feel there are three key societal members who can make a difference. They are the father, the mother and the teachers. As teachers, we are called to impart good knowledge to the young generation to prepare them to lead our country into prosperity. Dear students, it's your duty to be responsible towards your country. Dear students, it's your duty to be a good citizen for the betterment of your nation. I would like to express my sincere thanks to the school management, Sabida ma'am, my colleagues, for giving me such a wonderful opportunity to talk about the day. Happy Republic Day. Thank you all. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Chitra ma'am. That was a great speech. Now, I invite Hanumant Raj sir to express our love for the country through a patriotic song.
Thank you. ನವು ಎಂದು ಮರೆಯದ ಭಾರತ ರತ್ನವು ನೀನಾಗು ಹಿಂದೂಸ್ತಾನವು ಎಂದು ಮರೆಯದ ಭಾರತ ರತ್ನವು ನೀನಾಗು ಕನ್ನಡ ಹಿರಿಮೆಯ ಮಗನಾಗು ಕನ್ನಡ ನುಡಿಯ ಸಿರಿಯಾಗು ಹಿಂದೂಸ್ತಾನವು ಎಂದು ಮರೆಯ ಭಾರತ ರತ್ನವು ನೀನಾಗು ದೇಶದ ಬಡವರ ಕಂಬನಿ ಒರೆಸುವ ನಾಯಕ ನೀನಾಗು ಭಾರತ ದೇಶದ ಬಡವರ ಕಂಬನಿ ಒರೆಸುವ ನಾಯಕ ನೀನಾಗು ಭಾರತೀಯರ ವಿಶ್ವ ಪ್ರೇಮವ ಮೆರೆಸುವ ಜ್ಞಾನಿ ನೀನಾಗು ಭಾರತೀಯರ ಭವ್ಯ ಭವಿಷ್ಯ ಬೆಳಗುವ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನಿ ನೀನಾಗು ಬೆಳಗುವ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನಿ ನೀನಾಗು ಹಿಂದೂಸ್ತಾನವು ಎಂದು ಮರೆಯ ಭಾರತ ರತ್ನವು ನೀನಾಗು
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸರ್ ಸೊ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡೇ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಯೋರ್ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ and try to build a better future for all of us. We all are proud to be an Indian. The day had been wonderful. I thank you all. With this, we end the day here. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.